heading somewhere to get the car fixed. It was a great experiment. It turned out like an experiment would, you know, but I want my car to look good. Now, I'm not looking for a perfect car. You know, I drive this car, but I'm looking for a car that for the average person that doesn't know anything about cars whatsoever, I want them to be able to walk up to and be like, wow, that's different. That's a nice car. And not know anything about cars or know what went into it or anything like that. And I see that paint is not my expertise, and it's very time consuming, extremely time consuming. And I've got too many other things that's way more important than to burn a lot of time trying to learn how to paint. I don't got time for that. So we are on the way to Colombia. We'll drop the car off to hopefully get a better paint job, at least a better paint job than I could have put on the BMW. So let's keep riding.
There's the car, and let's look it over. Let's see how good or bad a less than $400 paint job from Econo Paint actually turns out.
$77 for
this paint job on this BMW? And honestly, it all comes down to managing your expectations. What do you expect? And coming into this paint job, I wasn't expecting much, okay? I like to experiment and to see how good or bad things will turn out if you try them a certain way. So this is what happens if you were to not take anything off your car and have them paint it, have them spray it down and paint it. So the paint costs like $270 something or $250, $249 for 1 year. And then they said they needed to do a deep sanding because it had a lot of tiger stripes and stuff like that and uneven paint. That was like another $125. So that left us to $377 altogether, $377 even. And the car doesn't look terrible. Now, yes, the car is a 5 to 10 footer. But again, I wasn't looking for a perfect finish on this car. It is a single stage, it is black, but you know what? I'm truthfully not mad at how it came out. Yes, we have some orange peel going on, and in some spots it is worse than others. This side of the car here, this driver's side, doesn't look as bad, but that passenger side looks a whole lot worse than one side. But there are some spots that are amazingly smooth that came out really good. Now, one of the things that I will say is worthwhile you doing is, hey, if you can drop a car off to one of these cheap paint places, strip as much stuff off of the car as you can. I didn't do that. I didn't strip off the roof rack, and because of that, they didn't move the roof rack when I told them to. They left it on and they painted the car as is. So now, under here, look at that. That's what that looks like. That sucks, that's terrible. But you know what, we will make that work. I can always fix that, and that's not a problem at all. So guys, we finally got the car straightened out as far as paint for the most part. Again, I'm not building a show car. I'm building a car for me that I can bash and beat and just daily, and it's gonna take those chips and scratches, and we're gonna put the miles on it, and I won't cry because of it. So there it is guys, one more good look at it, and honestly, it's time for tint. I need to get the windows working so I can go ahead and tint it out. Then we need to work on the whole front bumper situation, which I have not addressed in any video just yet. That's gonna be an awesome addition to the channel. And guys, we are making progress. I like the way it looks. Some people don't like the balloon tires on it. It's gonna all come together soon enough. Just be patient. And there it is. This is a paint job from Maaco, Econo Paint. This is what you would get by when you pay them for one of their budget specials. There it is.
So guys, you tell me, do you like the E36 in white? Do you like it in Victory Gold? Do you like it in flat black? Or do you like it in this shiny black? You let me know in the comment section below, guys. But honestly, I like the way it looks. Like, it looks pretty good, if I do say so myself. Obviously, some spots that we need to fix. I don't know if I can, obviously not wet sand single paint, single stage, but maybe, just maybe, we can compound and buff it, and it'll get a little bit more shine, and maybe it can get rid of just some of the orange peel. Who knows? Comment section below, let me know. But guys, if you enjoyed the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. If you wanna tell me I'm an idiot for buying a super cheap paint job for my car, you can do that too. But anyway, I will catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.